In the IFC Scheme Setup dialog, select the following item in the containment structure: IFC Object, IFC Product, IFC Element, IFC Building Element, IFC Wall. Then click the Create Property button at the bottom of the dialog. The Create IFC Property dialog opens, where you can specify the property set name, property name and type, and value type. Let us create a custom property for the IFC wall element type. When we are finished, the list on the right will show this property for IFC wall. Also, the item IFC wall will be shown in bold type to indicate that one or more custom IFC properties are defined for it. Let's now select the IFC building element item on the left and create another custom IFC property. The property set name is the same as with the previous IFC property, so they will be grouped together. Let's now select IFC wall again on the left, and we can see that now there are two IFC properties listed for the IFC wall type. Since their property set names are the same, they're grouped together. One of the IFC properties is listed in blue, which means that this is a derived IFC property, which was defined for an item higher in the hierarchy. Therefore, it applies to all IFC element types under that item in the hierarchy. In parentheses, the source IFC element type of the property is shown. The other IFC property is shown in black, which means it was defined for this IFC element type. The red cross before its name shows you that you can delete this IFC property here if you need to. There is no red cross before the other IFC property. On the left, you'll have to select the type in parentheses, and there you can delete the other IFC property since this is the place it was defined. If you wish to delete all IFC properties currently in the scheme, you may use the Clear All button of the dialog. If we now click the Apply button to accept changes, then go to the Wall Settings dialog and go to the Manage IFC Properties dialog, we can see that there's a new IFC property set available. If we expand it, we can see both custom IFC properties we defined. We can check either or both to be available for use in the Settings dialog. If we check the same in another tool, for example the Slab Tools Settings dialog, we can see the same IFC property set we defined. However, here we find only the custom IFC property we defined for the IFC building element type, which applies to all IFC element types below it in the hierarchy. The other defined custom IFC property was defined for the IFC wall type, so it's not available for other element types.